Modal dispersion is an effect of multimode fiber. But what is it exactly and how is it compensated? If you want to find out more, stick around and we'll check it out. Before we talk about modal dispersion, let's first have a quick look on the effect that dispersion in general has on the optical data transmission signal. Now, with optical data transmission, we have a sequence of light pulses that go through the fiber cable. On the other side, we've got the receiver that detects those pulse signals and that then converts it back to an electrical signal. Now, the point is that at the beginning of that transmission line, we've got these nice, clean, crisp pulse signals. But while they are traveling through the fiber cable, those light pulses, they start to broaden, they start to disperse. Now, with an individual pulse, that isn't really such a big problem. But if we're talking about a sequence of pulses, then you will see that at some point they actually start bleeding into each other. And that means that the receiver actually won't be able to distinguish between the individual pulses, meaning that it can't detect the signal properly. And this effect happens much faster the higher the data rate, because we then have more pulses in a shorter period of time for the higher data rates. Now let's have a look at the multimode fiber cable, or to be more precise, how the light passes through the multimode fiber cable. As the name says, multimode says that the light takes multiple modes through the fiber cable. What is a mode? Well, the official description is a guided light propagation path, or we could also say the different ways the light signal takes through the fiber cable. Now, we're not talking about different pulses, but we're talking about the exact same pulse, the same flash of light, but that will take different paths through the fiber cable. Now, the number of paths and the number of modes actually is determined by the core diameter, the wavelength of the optical signal, and also the index contrast between core and cladding. And to give you an idea how many modes we're talking, so if we've got a core diameter of 50 micrometers, a wavelength of 850 nanometers, and an index contrast of 0.015, we will end up at 683 different modes. So 683 different paths the light takes through the fiber cable. Now, the point is that depending on the mode, the path that the light signal takes, it has to cover different distances, because the first order mode is much shorter than, for example, these higher order modes. And that then results in the modal dispersion. Because the light takes these different modes, it will actually end up spreading, because that same pulse signal will be spreading apart and be arriving at the same part of the fiber cable at different times. So how can we compensate this? Well, to understand that, let's first have a quick look at the early designs of a multimode fiber cable. And then we had the step index profile, meaning the core had a constant refractive index and the cladding had a much lower refractive index, meaning that the light passing through the fiber core experienced a total reflection when it hit upon the cladding. Now, the improvement and also the compensation of the modal dispersion was achieved by introducing the graded index fiber core. And what is the point is here that the refractive index of the core gradually decreases from the center outwards. So in the center, we've got a higher refractive index than on the outside of the fiber core. And an important effect to understand is that light passing through a higher refractive index will travel slightly slower than light passing through a lower refractive index. So now let's have a look at this diagram again. And what that then means is that the modes that have got the shorter distance are actually traveling through the higher refractive index, meaning those light elements are slowed down, whereas the higher order modes, they are going through the part that has a lower refractive index. In other words, that light signal is traveling slightly faster, and that then compensates the dispersion. And the other effect is, because we've got this graded index of the fiber core, we don't have the hard total reflection, but instead the slightly curved reflection, meaning that the longer distances, so the higher modes, are actually the distance is also shortened. And the result is that the dispersion is reduced quite drastically. Now, this isn't a new development, by far not. I mean, the graded index fiber cable was actually introduced in the late 60s, early 70s. But because of the graded index fiber, we are still using multimode fiber cables, even for those high data rates, but of course for shorter distances. So I hope you learned something today and that you enjoyed this video. If so, please leave a comment. And of course, remember to follow our channel so you get your regular dose of brain snacks. And see you in one of the next videos. Bye-bye.